In our Commitment 2012 coverage, Mitt Romney's running mate, the main attraction tonight as the Republican National Convention continues in Tampa.
Vice presidential candidate Paul Ryan will hit the big stage in primetime in what is his biggest speech of his career, at least to date.
Action News reporter Gulson Dart of our sister station KCRA is in Tampa with more.
Well, Dan, Aaron, I got to tell you, day three right now at the RNC is in full swing. We're listening right now to comments from Puerto Rico Governor Luis Fortuño. He's getting the crowd all riled up, ready for the next speaker. We also heard earlier from Senator John McCain, who talked for about 15 minutes about how he supports Mitt Romney, the man who he defeated in the primary and in the Republican presidential race last time around in 2008. But, of course, tonight is really all about Paul Ryan. And what is he going to say? Well, we took some time out today to talk to some California delegates about Paul Ryan's big appearance tonight, his conservative views. And then on another topic, we talked about how all those delegates are holding up in this humid Tampa weather.
God bless each and every one of you, and God bless the United States of America.
After last night's performance by Ann Romney, California delegates enjoying a lunchtime barbecue feel like they're cooking.
I thought she spoke right from her heart. My wife texted me in the middle of the event and said, I'm crying. And I was too.
Tonight's main speaker, Vice Presidential candidate Paul Ryan, may have a more difficult time connecting with moderate conservative women because of his position on abortion. The devout Catholic is against it in cases of rape.
I'm a right to life supporter, so I support that position with him as well.
And the reality is that as the Vice President of the United States, he's going to have virtually no influence at all on the issue of abortion.
Politics aside, there was another big topic today.
You got a little something right there.
Oh, I got a lot of sweat.
Tampa's very un-California humidity.
How come you're not sweating? I mean, look, this is, what's going
because,
on?
Because I'm in a tank top appropriately dressed for Tampa, Florida. You're in a tie and not appropriately
this is,
dressed.
Look at my, I mean, this is crazy. Look at my back here.
I'm telling the people that live here in Tampa, I can take 115 in Sacramento versus the 80 degrees here with the humidity. It's just not for a California girl.
Yeah, or a California guy for that matter. Now, it may get hot for Ryan in the next few days because his critics are already starting to hammer his plan for economic reform, and they say that he has no foreign policy experience. We'll see if he'll address any of those issues when he gets a chance to speak later on tonight. Also coming up in just a few minutes on the podium will be former Governor Tim Pawlenty, who Mitt Romney beat earlier in the year during the primaries. And then, of course, the big event later tonight, Vice Presidential candidate Paul Ryan will be speaking. Reporting live in Tampa, I'm Gulston Dart. And Dan and Aaron, I don't know about it, but I'm sure you guys would not enjoy the humidity here. It's just way too much.
We're from the Midwest, so we know what you're talking about.
You go ahead and enjoy it. Very good. Gulston, thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
That's why we're in California.
That's right.
Also, another campaign season item that we want to tell you about. It's our new KSBW Hearst Television election app. This is in addition to our Commitment 2012 coverage that you can find on our website. Beginning today, you can download this app for either the Android or the iPhone. It is your mobile home for national and local election news. It's free. You can find links to download it by going to ksbw.com or by searching Hearst Election in the App Store. Really cool stuff. Keep you up to date throughout the election season.